So we've reached day four and I could be losing all my credibility, or maybe not. You'll find out. Hey guys, in this video, we're going to be going through day four of our scaling our agency to 10K in 30 days. Now, if you've watched the previous videos before, we went through putting together the offer, we went through the initial setup of building the funnel. And so now we've actually come to the point where getting calls booked on our calendar, and it's amazing. It has actually gone a lot better than I thought. Literally, I think over the last 2 to 3 days, we've booked 10 calls and the cost per call is under $20 per call. That is the power of having a good offer and the four parts to having a good offer, which I went through on the previous video. Now guys, if you're watching this video, please like and subscribe. It helps the channel. And if you're wanting to fast track your growth in your agency, click the link below. You can book a call, speak with our team. We'll be happy to put a custom roadmap together for you. Now, what I've realized in this process is what we're doing in scaling the agency right now is effectively three things. So the first thing is we always start with the offer and the four parts to that offer. The second thing is that we've created a client acquisition channel. Now the fastest way to create a client acquisition channel is with paid ads. Now the third thing that we're doing is we're creating a conversion mechanism. So this is what I want to focus on today, and we're going to break this into two parts because there's a lot of information that goes into knowing how to convert customers. Now, in simple terms, to convert a customer, you need to get them on a sales call and you need to communicate what you do in such a way that communicates value more than the money that you're asking for. So people will buy when they see the value that you're offering is more than the money that they're exchanging it for. Now, how do you do that? I've found that there are primarily four things that you're doing on those sales conversations. Number one is that you need to build rapport. Now, building rapport is actually simple. It's like a couple of things. The first thing is showing them that you're a normal professional person. So you look good, wearing good professional clothes, you talk normally, and you're a friendly person. If you're angry or aggressive and you look disheveled, you're not going to win over deals. Now, the second thing to rapport is you actually build a connection with the prospect. This is where you share interests or you talk about things that you both care about. Now, that takes time. But it takes time to get good at that, but it is important that you build rapport, because honestly, a lot of people have said this, that they don't remember what you said on a sales call, but they do remember how you made them feel. So it's very important that you make them feel good on the sales call. Number two is that you need to identify a problem. There needs to be a problem that you can effectively identify, and then you need to get your prospect to explain what that problem is. Now, there are three steps to identifying the problem. The first step is to get a clear statement of what the problem actually is. So a good example is if I go to the doctor says, "What has brought you here?" And I'm going to say, "I've got the flu." Now, the second thing is, you need to know the depth of the problem. Now, if we use the doctor metaphor, the doctor's gonna say, "How long have you had your flu for? How bad is it? Is it a raspy cough? Is it causing you to have a fever? What is the extent of the problem?" So if I was talking to a business and they're unable to get sales calls, I'm gonna say, "You know, how bad is it? How long has it been since you've had your last sales call? You know, tell me about that." You want to dig into those problems. And in doing so, getting your prospect to verbalize the problem that they have is getting them to sell themselves on why they need to change the current situation. Now, the third part of the problem is the impact of the problem. How is the problem affecting them both personally and on a business level? How is the problem affecting them both personally and on a business level? Now, when you get to that level of understanding their need, you create a sense of urgency and a state of action where they realize my situation is not good, I need to move away from it. Now, number three is the solution. This is where you pitch them on what you can do for them. The pitch really comes down to two things. You've got the promise and then you've got the process. Now, the promise is stating a clear outcome or result that you can provide for them. The process is how it actually works. Now, if you can clearly show them your promise and the process, which backs up how the promise works. Then you move into the last stage of the call, which is being able to close. Now, being able to close comes with practice, but really what it comes down to is getting down to the root objection and overcoming that root objection. Now, there are three typical objections. It could be price, it could be partner, or it could be fear. Now, if it's a price objection, it means that you haven't actually communicated enough value. And if that happens, you need to go back and explain why the value of what you do is worth the price that you're asking for. If it's a partner objection, I typically like to ask for the context of that partnership. Is it necessary that partner is involved, and what are the implications of that partnership? And the third thing is fear, and this is very common. If people feel fear, you need to know how to overcome that fear. Now, I've found that this is a combination of, again, getting down to the root objection, and then number two is using a series of sequences and questions to instill confidence in them. Now, overlaying this whole thing is that you need to have certainty and confidence in your product. So that is why you should spend a lot of time building a good product that works, in conjunction with obviously booking calls and closing deals. So guys, that is the four-part process to running a sales call effectively. Now, tomorrow we've got our first closing call with our client that we've just booked in. So hopefully that goes well. I'll let you guys know how it goes, and I'll speak to you soon. Cheers.